get loose and produce. Alright, what's up, Homo sapiens? I just wanted to show you a pretty cool filter in Serum, which can give you nice tonal basses. Alright, so I've got some basic house drums here. So now we're gonna try to make a bass sound to support them. Now let's load up a Serum. And at this point, it doesn't really matter what waveforms we want to work with, because, yeah, you can make a bass sound out of anything, you know? But just to keep it simple, let's just use a saw. Get a sub-oscillator direct out, because we don't want the effects to affect our low end. Let's give it some voices to just give us some stereo information. Turn off randomize, because we don't want this shit to be moving around too much. We want to be able to control it. Filter some high end off, because we're going to be distorting it. Let's give it some dimension, turn off the hyper. And let's distort it. Tube distortion is pretty solid, let's see what it sounds like. Whoa, that's badass. So this is where the magic's gonna come in. Got this thing called the Combs filter. Now check it out. You hear all those new harmonies it creates? It's very cool for house or for trap, just bass sounds, to have all these like higher harmonies and higher artifacts coming from this filter. We can enunciate these by compressing the sound. And I briefly talked about compression before. What compression does, it kind of brings those lower volume ones up higher, and it squashes the higher volume peaks, and it makes the sound kind of like flat out. If we do it after the comb filter, it'll affect those peaks that it's creating, right? I like to use the multiband function because I have control over the different bands. Let's see what it sounds like now. Let's see what happens if we add another oscillator. Let's do a square. Ooh. All right, let's throw it on a channel. And I'm just gonna sidechain it. All right, let's make some notes. That sounds like some cool notes. All right, let's play with that. Because we're bass house maniacs, we like to skip the first kick. Ooh, fire. Whoa, we're fucking abstract. Alright, so let's recap real quick. First, we pick a wavetable that we like. It could be a saw, it could be a square, it could be whatever you want. Give it some unison to give it some stereo information. You filter off the really ugly high end, which is gonna be brought out with distortion compression later on. We're gonna send a sub direct out so it doesn't get affected by all these effects. That's gonna give us the solid low end that we're gonna need in the mix. Then, cause we're crazy, we're gonna add a second oscillator with a different wavetable. Reduce the octave on it to give us some mid-range feel. Then giving it some hyper for some room, some depth. Distorting it, you can play around with the different distortions. Tube is solid because it doesn't destroy the sound too much. And then the magic was in the comb filter. And you can modulate the amount of the comb filter with this mix here. And then you compress the whole sound together just to bring up the lower artifacts and then squash down the really noisy transient ones to make the sound thick, because we like it thick. All right, hopefully you found that interesting, and have a great quarantine. Bye.